website where you can get information about litigation, you can get information about candidates, you can get information analyzing what the meaning of Supreme Court decisions are. It has been invaluable for Wisconsin. We have, well, we do still live in what the Wall Street Journal called Alabama North. It is not a good place to be, let me tell you, given the nature of our activist Supreme Court decisions. That website with the upcoming elections for the Supreme Court has been invaluable to the citizens of Wisconsin. Ballotpedia goes even further. Its initiatives, its ballot initiatives, it's the referendum process, candidates, litigation that is out there, and the Sunshine Awards, my personal favorite, exposing government to the people so you have access to the information as well. And you are invited to reach out your hand and provide information that you have. There are three amazing people who have been doing this already, one of whom cannot be with us tonight, and I'm going to introduce them. I will begin with John Wynne from Sioux Falls, South Dakota. John is considered to be one of the most effective contributors to the Ballotpedia website. He has helped Ballotpedia become one of the top 10 election websites in 2008 and the number one source of election information, thanks to people like John. So without further ado, please, a warm round of applause for John Wynne. You cannot be here with us.
Thank you, Vicki. Thank you, Sam Adams Alliance. I am honored to be receiving this award, and sorry I can't be there in person to accept it. I actually started using Ballotpedia Wiki for my job as a petition drive manager to find out more information about ballot measures across the country, including ones I personally dealt with. With the help of Kristen McMurray at the Sam Adams Alliance, I learned how to add content and contribute to the wealth of information. Ballotpedia is a great source. I encourage everyone to check it out. Thank you.
And then I may call up to the stage Fred Baldwin and Seth Cooper. Where are you guys? I can't see you. Fred is the winner of our Sunshine Review Award. Fred is a freelance writer. Here's Fred coming up to the stage right now. He's been active in school board politics for 15 years, and for the past couple of years has been working feverishly and tirelessly for transparency in the process of government. He was inspired, he said, to get involved in the idea of transparency after he was able to witness some questionable activities taking place during teacher contract negotiations. Fred says that he plans to try to promote the concept of the people being able to access, which in many, many districts around the country are secret negotiations between the teachers' unions and the school boards. Fred has filed over 40 Sunshine Reviews, setting a new league record. So Fred Baldwin from Carlisle, Pennsylvania, our Sunshine Award winner, please, a round of applause. I'm going to introduce Seth as well, and I'm going to step aside, and these two wonderful guys are going to come up and tell you what they're all about. Seth, who's right there, is our Judgepedia winner. He's from Fairfax, Virginia. He's active in policy and information technology in his work as an information technician. You have the longest title. You're going to have to tell people what your title is. But what he does is he works with information technology and also is legal counsel for the amazing American Legislative Exchange Council that so many of us find so beneficial to our research and finding out more about what's going on in the legislative process. While he's been at Alex, Seth has worked to provide content and analysis, which I find incredibly valuable, on Supreme Court candidates, specifically Washington Supreme Court candidates. Can I tell him your greatest accomplishment? Seth says it's great. This is how you know this guy is a great fighter. This is how you know the guy is not going to sit down and take anything. Seth says his greatest accomplishment was defeating the entire 8th grade dodgeball team single-handedly as a 7th grader.
Communications and Information Technology Task Force Director at the American Legislative Exchange Council. I make up something shorter when my family asks me what I do. I once had a job that had me as I don't even remember. In any case, to receive this award, it's an honor and it's a challenge as well, because Judgepedia is a relatively new site and our work is cut out for us. And what we're hoping to do is use a new media platform to make information available to citizens so they can answer a couple of important questions. Are there judges, there are federal judges, state elected judges, people who are committed to the written constitution and laws, or the judicial activists who make decisions based on their own personal opinions? It's very hard to get good, relevant information about this kind of stuff. When I go to legal conferences, I'll hear legal elites who will say there's no such thing as judicial activism. That might be true if we had no such thing as a written constitution or written laws. Those are beyond mere opinion. They protect the idea of limited government and individual rights to life, liberty, and property, the rights of citizens, of parents, property owners, gun owners, and taxpayers. So if judicial activism is a myth, then limited government and individual rights are a myth. Now, I happen to know that the good people of America and Joe Plumber's America know better than this, and so the challenge is up to me and like-minded folks to get that information out there. And in my work, I think my work is just starting on this, and so I really have to live up to this award, not simply for state courts, but expanding work into federal courts, and finally, to the area of federal judicial nominees. I was in D.C. at a law conference yesterday discussing the issue of the president's upcoming nominees to the federal bench. And Senator Rick Santorum really laid the stakes out. He said, these nominees will change America. So I think it is very important that we get information where we have judges who are being elevated to circuit courts of appeal or to the U.S. Supreme Court. We need to know what these nominees' records are, what they've decided, and why. And that's what I'm committed to do. So thank you very much.
Something called the Wikiteer Award, they'll soon not want to post it. And in a sense, what I'm trying to do in a very small way is to use the cliche level playing field. My particular area of interest is public school board and teacher union negotiations. I've been through some, and I came to realize that the issues, where everyone comes out on the merits of the case, get blurred in the process of rewards, secrecy, rewards, gamesmanship. It's an unequal contest. On the one hand, for the most part, you have amateurs, often inexperienced, these are school boards. On the other hand, you have teams of professionals, backed by national and state unions with huge war chests, huge computer banks, who know carefully all the rules of play. The only way that the little guys on the home team, the taxpayers and parents, and most above all the students, really have a chance is when the public understands the issues and get accurate information. So I'm very grateful to the Sam Adams Alliance, not only for this award, but for providing the platform. I'm grateful to the staff, Sunshine Review, for introducing me to Wikis, teaching me the language, and I hope they'll continue to clean up my post. And I'm also grateful to the Commonwealth Foundation of Pennsylvania, a free market, limited government organization that introduced me to the Sunshine Review in the first place, as well as providing other kind of help and support. So thank you all, and God bless.